Hi, I'm Jack Kush. We're going to talk today about anti-nuclear antibodies, or ANAs. ANAs are immunologic tests that are often used to identify autoimmune disorders. It has most closely been aligned with the diagnosis of systemic lupus erythematosus, but in no way is this a specific test for lupus. It may be found in a variety of other autoimmune conditions. It may be found in elderly and healthy people just as well. It is a very sensitive and poorly specific assay for autoimmune disease. It is often done by ELISA testing, although there are many methods in which it can be done. But it's important to note that when it should not be used as a screening test. Again, and it has very, very low specificity and can be seen in a number of other disorders. So what you're looking for is the titer, the strength of the autoantibody that's being directed against nuclear constituents, antigens, and the pattern of staining, which may tell you also about which antigens are being recognized by these tests. So a positive result is determined locally. It's determined by whatever is normal for that area. So meaning that they have to take and establish a cutoff point that will lead to a 5% false positive rate in the local area. So that is established by local laboratories, which is why you'll see in some labs a positive result may begin at 1 to 160 in a dilutional assay, or maybe as low as 1 to 40 in other institutions or labs. It also may be established by ELISA and read out as international units. The indication to do this test is based on the presence of clinical features and other manifestations that would make you think the person has lupus or a closely related autoimmune disorder like scleroderma, myositis, Sjogren's syndrome, etc. In fact, while 99% of lupus patients will have a positive ANA, ANAs will also be seen in as much as 75% of patients with scleroderma, 50% of patients with inflammatory myositis, and up to 80 to 90% of patients with Sjogren's. 40% of people with rheumatoid arthritis have positive titers or positive results for lupus. But again, you need to have a requisite number of clinical criteria to make ordering the test a useful result. When used as a screening test, again, you're going to get way more positive results than you want to see, and they will be meaningless. So I tell my patients that there are 20 million Americans in the United States that have a positive ANA, but there's only 300,000 people with lupus. Hence, there's only 1 in 90 chance that a positive ANA means that it's due to lupus. Maybe another 5 out of those 100 chances are due to other autoimmune causes like thyroiditis, chronic liver disease, chronic renal disease, being elderly, having cancer, primary biliary cirrhosis, etc. But the vast majority of them have no important cause and are not likely to turn into positive lupus at some later date. So be wise in the use of this very common and very cheap test. It's not a screening test. It should be a confirmatory test for the diagnosis of lupus.